Google Maps is the goldmine of data, but only if you know how to dig it efficiently. Let me show you how. But first, why scrape Google Maps? Picture having access to business names, addresses, phone numbers, ratings, and reviews at your fingertips. Whether you're building a database, optimizing SEO strategies, or making informed business decisions, this data is invaluable. But here's the deal, doing this manually would take forever, and traditional scraping methods might not cut it. That's where our SERP Scraping API comes in. It's the most efficient way to scrape Google Maps, and to show you just how powerful it is, we'll take on a real-world challenge. Imagine you're a pizza maker with big dreams of expanding your business into Berlin. You must scout the local competition and gather insights to dominate the market. Using the API, we'll scrape the data for pizza in Berlin so you can see exactly how to do it for yourself. Ready? Let's get started. First, log into your Smartproxy dashboard. On the left-hand menu, click Scraping APIs and select Pricing. Then, select the SERP target group and choose a subscription plan that suits your needs or opt for a 7-day free trial. This will take you to the heart of the action. Hit the Create New Project button and in the search bar, type Google Maps. This shortcut will help you find the Google Maps template super quickly. Next, in the query field, type in your targeted keyword. I'll enter pizza in Berlin. Want to scrape multiple searches at once? Just enable the bulk query option and pop in more search phrases, each on a new line. Now, let's tweak the scraper settings to get the results we need. First, head to the parameters section and set the geolocation. Since we're looking for pizza in Berlin, we'll choose Germany. This ensures we get results as if we're browsing locally. Next, select the language for the content and the domain for Google. Then, pick the device type. Let's say we want to scrape as if we're on a smartphone. Select mobile. If you want to keep things organized, assign a session ID to this template. Pagination settings are next. Here, decide how many SERP pages you want to grab and where to start. For most scrapes, starting with page 1 is fine. Now, there's a neat option for those targeting specific industries. Under target specific settings, you can add guest numbers or date ranges, great for hotel data. But since we're after pizza spots, we'll skip this for now. Finally, head to other parameters to enable extras like JS rendering for dynamic pages or auto correction for typos. Done with the setup? Click save and scrape and let the magic happen. A few moments later, your output will appear on the right side of the screen in HTML format and as a live preview. You can copy or export it as an HTML document. Want to run the scraping task regularly? You may set recurring requests by hitting schedule. First, specify how often you want it to run. You can opt for preset periods or a custom interval. Then, choose how to receive the results. On this tab, you'll find Google Drive and email options. But you can find even more integration methods, like Zapier, in the SERP section's integrations tab. Hit save and you've automated the whole process. And that's it. With just a few clicks, we've successfully scraped Google Maps for pizza in Berlin. Now it's your turn to get the freshest insights. Grab a free trial for our SERP Scraping API with a link in the description. Or watch our other web scraping tutorials, and I'll see you next time.